This is part one of my tanking guide for Terra players. I will go over some general tips, look at some differences between the tank classes, and talk about gear and card setups. I will also talk about common mistakes I see new tanks make. Parts 2A, 2B, and 2C will be about Lancer, Brawler, and Warrior tanks specifically. The guides for Lancer and Brawler will follow soon. The Warrior tank guide will have to wait a bit, because I first need to learn more about the class myself, and I want to make some other class guides first. Anyway, let's get started. The main purpose of a tank is to keep the boss's attention throughout the fight. That's what we call holding aggro. Every time a player attacks the boss, or heals or resurrects another player, they gain some aggro. The boss will focus on whoever has the highest amount of aggro at that moment. The more damage you do, the more aggro you draw. Tanks draw more aggro for the same amount of damage done though, and they have shouts which they can use to instantly grab the boss's attention. If you see this orange symbol on the floor around your character, that means you have aggro. There is also something called secondary aggro, which is represented by the same symbol, but in purple. Bosses will sometimes target players who don't have aggro with secondary aggro, aim an attack at them, and then turn back towards the tank. The boss will follow the person with aggro, and will be turned towards them most of the time. This means that tanks are the ones who control where the boss is standing, and which way it is turned. Positioning the boss such that the DPS players can attack efficiently is crucial. For example, on the second boss in RK9, it is important to keep the boss in the middle, so that DPS players are not forced to stay in the area where the big stamps come down. Even turning the boss's back towards the wall or constantly moving or turning the boss will make it harder for the DPS players and the healers to do their jobs. If there is a clear reason to move or rotate the boss, like an AoE being placed underneath him for example, then turning the boss is a better choice than moving him, because it will be easier to hold aggro when trying to turn than when trying to move. If the tank is trying to move the boss, then DPS players often need a moment to notice, or they are just too greedy for high DPS numbers, so they might steal aggro before the boss starts moving as well. When you're dead, you don't have any aggro at all, and DPS classes are not designed to deal with the attacks that bosses aim at tanks, so tank players need to be good at surviving. If a tank dies, then the DPS players might start dying as well. This is also why the healers typically try to resurrect a dead tank first, before resurrecting a dead DPS. Don't rely on the healer to keep you alive while you face tank everything. Healers have a lot of responsibilities, and you will slow down the run if the healer doesn't have time to buff the party or debuff the boss. Or even worse, if they have to let DPS players die just to save you. You have skills for blocking and iframing, and you need to learn which boss mechanics can be blocked, which ones you need to iframe, and which ones you have to avoid completely. A good tank can solo dungeons such as Red Refuge without taking any damage at all. Dealing as much damage as possible while tanking is not only important for holding aggro. Nowadays, tanks do a significant share of the total party DPS, and they increase the damage output of DPS players by debuffing the boss. Timing the blocking skills correctly is important on any of the tank classes, because a well-timed block will result in perfect defense, which increases the damage reflected back to the boss. Also, some boss mechanics can only be blocked with perfect defense, but cannot be blocked with a poorly timed skill. Compared to brawlers and warriors, lancers gain more aggro for a certain amount of damage done. This also means that lancers typically do less damage, however the buffs they give to the party make up for that. Brawlers and warriors rely more on DPS, and lose aggro easier if their DPS drops. Lancers need to block manually. With that I mean they have to use Standfast, Wallop, Super Leap or Onslaught at the right times in order to block boss attacks. They also have a shield called Guardian Barrier, which has a long cooldown time, but it can be very useful in some dungeons since it can save party members from some one-shot mechanics. Brawlers have a skill called Growing Fury, which auto-blocks boss attacks as long as you keep attacking. So you only have to make sure you time the attacks well to get perfect defense. Warriors block in a similar manner to Lancers. They have cross parry, which is similar to Standfast on Lancer, and they have some other skills that block while attacking. Berserkers can tank sort of, but in harder dungeons they are not really an option, because they lack the ability to get perfect defense. I see them more as a DPS class that can also tank lower dungeons or save the party in case the tank disconnects. A very skilled Berserker might still be able to tank any dungeon, but that is way beyond my level of skill, so I won't make a guide for Berserker tanks. All of the tank classes do physical damage, so when choosing a set of gear, make sure you get the version with physical amplification. In the current patch, this would mean you'd need annihilation gear rather than dark light. But with the new upcoming gear, just look at the fixed stats to figure out which version is for magic classes and which one is for physical classes. Which gear options are best depends on the class. For Lancer, physical resistance is the best choice on the chest piece and on the boots, since this will increase the damage of their shield skills, and some other skills will profit from it as well. Physical crit power is the best choice for weapon and gloves. For the innerwear, I did not find any up-to-date information, but I would suggest to go with physical resistance on Lancer. For brawlers, physical amplification is the best choice for the whole gear set, including the innerwear, since it will increase the amount of damage reflected by perfect defense. For warriors, physical crit power will increase the damage of scythe and aerial scythe, so it is the best choice for the weapon, gloves and innerwear. Physical amplification is the best choice for the boots and chest piece. Physical resistance can be a good choice as well, but only if you use your warrior for tanking exclusively. In general, physical amplification, physical resistance and physical crit power stats are decent choices for any of the tank classes. And physical piercing, ability to ignore physical resistance, HP, crit factor and power will also be fine if you're not willing to spend tons of gold for perfect stats. Which cards to use depends on your collection level and which cards you have unlocked already. You should try to increase physical amplification and physical crit power by as much as possible. The best cards for that are Hasmina, Fire Dragon and Training Center Draco Norina. Other good options are Blood Festival Allen, Hallwrath, Diamond Dragon, Energy Transfer Post and High Watch. Crayfish can also be useful if you haven't reached crit cap yet and you still have card slots and 4 points left at the end. If you're unable to hold aggro, then you can also use cards to boost the amount of aggro gained from your attacks. The best cards for that are Elion and Sapphire Phoenix. The best side effects for increasing your DPS are the ones called At Last United and Piskivore. If you have trouble surviving, then Fellow Goblins will help you stay alive right after resurrecting. In case you don't have either one of those, then just use anything that increases the stats I recommended earlier. I sometimes see new players block for way too long without attacking, so they don't do enough damage and they lose aggro. On Brawler, it is rarely necessary to use the basic block, since Growing Fury blocks for you. on Warrior and Lancer, if you use Standfast or Cross Parry, then you should only use them while the boss's attack is hitting, and then go back to attacking. This might seem difficult when getting started with tanking or when trying to learn a new dungeon, but it will become easier with practice. Just blocking and using shouts to hold aggro might seem like a good idea when your party does low damage, but this won't be an option if the DPS players know how to play their class. Also, as I said earlier, tanks do a significant share of the total damage nowadays, so only blocking and shouting means the dungeon will take longer to complete. The next common mistake is the exact opposite of the first one. Some tanks don't block or iframe at all, but rely on the healer to keep them alive, while they face tank everything. This might work in easy dungeons if both the tank and healer are way overgeared, but in harder dungeons, it will only give two options to the healer. Either they let the DPS die and focus heal the tank, or they let the tank die and focus on the DPS. Either way, it's not a pleasant experience for anybody in the party, so make sure to learn how to block and dodge. Turning the boss should be avoided when possible. Sometimes I see tanks jump through the boss in order to dodge attacks. However, this will aim the next boss attack in direction of the DPS players. For ranged DPS, a 180 degree turn can be quite annoying if it happens too much, since the distance they have to cover to get back behind the boss is larger than for melee classes. It is way better to dodge backwards or sideways if necessary, and then walk or sprint back to where you were before dodging. Moving the boss without a good reason is even worse than turning him. Well, that concludes part 1 of my tanking guide. I looked at some Discord servers, as well as an old tanking guide on essential mana, in order to verify the information I gave in this video. You should join a class-specific Discord server to get the most up-to-date information, especially if you watched this video a few months after I uploaded it. You can find the links to any of the class-specific servers in the Terra Master Race server. It is a good place to start if you're looking for any information about Terra, or if you have general questions about the game. The link is in the description below. Let me know in the comments which tank class you prefer and why. If you have any questions or other comments, you may drop those below as well. I also do live streams on Twitch now, so if you want, you can drop in there and ask questions directly in chat. Anyway, leave a like if this video was helpful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching and see you next time.